Hey, welcome back, everybody. We're cruising through Isaiah 42 with our offerings to burst the bubble and break through the blood-brain barrier and wake up the lion, feed the beast, and make an offering to God in the temple. So, listen to the rhythm of your heartbeat and wake up the lion with an offering as we get to read Israel, blind and deaf. Now that we're awake, we can give praise and Hashem and offer the aroma and get down to some business. But what? Let me ask you a question. What is your father's business? The honey business. Your dad's in the honey business. There's an answer. But it's actually cannabis. Cannabis business. Canna butter. Canna bud. Bud. Butter. There's interesting parallels there. So anyways, let's focus on Israel blind and deaf. Okay? We just talked about Isaac, the father, giving the blessing to the son. Another son comes in, and he is blind, and he can't tell by the voice. The only sense that the blessing is given through is through the aroma of his clothes, and that is the flower of the field. Hear, you deaf. Look, you blind, and see. Who is blind but my servant, and deaf like the messenger I send? Who is blind like the one in covenant with me? Are you? Blind like the servant of the Lord. You have seen many things, but you pay no attention. Your ears are open, but you do not listen. It pleased the Lord, for the sake of his righteousness, to make his law great and glorious. But this is a people plundered and looted, all of them trapped in pits, or hidden away in prisons. They have become plunder with no one to rescue them, which only flips to there's a search party and there's a searchlight. At that point, how many puns can you make? It's a party. Where's your Bud Light? And the Bud Light, the search party, will see the plume of smoke as an SOS, and you then will be found, and you can wait patiently serving God until he saves all of us. So, they have become plunder with no one to rescue them, and now we have someone to rescue us. They have been made loot with no one to say, send them back. Which of you will listen to this? Which of you will hear the voice of cannabis? Or pay close attention in time to come? Who handed Jacob over to be loot and Israel to the plunderers? Was it not the Lord Hashem, against whom you have sinned? For they would not follow his ways, and they did not obey his laws. Time out, coach. I'm sorry. Can you follow? Can you obey? I just read in Jeremiah 7. In fact, we'll flip there real quick because That it's the command. It's in Jeremiah 7, just next chapter over. False religion, worthless. And it says, I gave them these commands. Where is it? I gave them these commands. And it says, sorry, I can't remember it. But it says, I gave them these commands, not only about burnt offerings and sacrifices, but I also said, obey me. So we have been told the incorrect story. We didn't know Hashem was the God of Israel, and we didn't know how to honor him and serve him and be in the aroma and presence of him and start to worship and say, oh my goodness, if you're the King of Kings and you're still alive, we should go back to, I don't know, 12th century, 15th century, and knights in shining armor and King Arthur's court, and sort of, should we listen to what the king has in decreed and follow it, never knowing that somebody's always listening and watching? Yeah, that's kind of how you're always in the influence of, I always want to do the right thing, whether the policeman is there or not, whether the teacher is watching me, or whether my mom and dad are with me or not, I know that they warn me, don't swear, or I'll wash your mouth out with soap, which is, I'm going to clean your mouth, I'm going to doff, clean, you're going to be washed up and ready to go have dinner. Set, ready? Okay. So, but this is a people plundered and looted, all of them trapped, with no one to say send them back. So which of you will listen to this or pay close attention in time to come? Who handed Jacob over? But you would not listen or obey or follow his way. So he poured out on them his burning anger, the violence of war. So if somebody ever asks you, why is God evil? No, he's not evil. He's pissed. He wrote an entire book. He took a long time to prepare this plant. It's the greatest thing in the world. And you could totally worship him in spirit, in thought, through him. And everybody just smokes weed. And then swears by another God. And then uses foul language. At that point, if he was right next to you, are you paranoid? There's one of the sensations. Paranoia. Paranoid, cannabinoid, paranoid, bi and pair, two. It's a 4x2. It's a 2x4 piece of wood he's going to whack over your head. Anyways, so how do we solve the anger of God? How do we quench the fire? We add cana, cane, Q-U-E-N-C-H, Q-N-H, cana, to the fire, and it becomes pleasing, and it's an aroma, and oh my goodness, God is then well pleased. And if he's well pleased, wouldn't he then say, this is my son with whom I'm well pleased, and then introduce him to the world? Well, at that point, I'm still waiting for that part, but I feel pretty confident that I'm actually his son, with the message of, hey, you guys should really listen to my dad. He's really a cool coach. He gave us cannabis, and at that point, you can do everything mental workout with him. Sounds pretty good. Join his team, right? So, he poured out on them his burning anger, the violence of war. It enveloped them in flames, in smoke. Yet, they did not understand. And there's to the point. He's going to get everybody stoned. It is a gateway drug. Yeah, gateway to heaven. It is heaven. That's what Christ is. He's the gate. And everybody just walks in and walks out, and they don't even know where they are. They're like, oh, just go to work, and I'm stoned and whatever. I want to breathe through my nose so I can get more high. I'm like, do you not realize that you're actually holding God's fragile flower that he created with all of his life's work, and you should give it a little bit more respect? Yeah. That's what we're talking about. A science project that humanity and the world and the heavens and the earth are created from. One seed. Now, do we have a little bit, I should really kind of sit up straight in class, right? So, he even handed Jacob over. Okay, so he's no joke. And then he pours out his anger so we can then give him an offering of food. It enveloped them in flames, yet they did not understand Proverbs. It consumed them, but they did not take it to heart. So it's food, it's knowledgeable, it's wisdom, it's Cana, it's honey, and it's blossom, and it's balsam. All of it is one seed. And then it gets to Isaiah 43, which is actually not, we're going to go into that next. So let's wake up the lions. See if I can do this. And talk about the song and the drink. So it's all about turning to a thought process. Can you conceive an idea in your mind with the help of cannabis that God gave it to us as the one thing we're lacking? His thoughts, his perspective, his wishes. He wishes that you would honor him with cannabis. That's all he wants. So I said, okay, I have no more diseases, I'm totally healed, and Baruch Hashem for song of praise to Hashem. Here we go. Empire. We woke up, they woke up the lions. Baruch Hashem. God bless.